Hello, I'm Mr. Armigeri, retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. So I read the New Testament in 1982. I wrote the exposition of Matthew in 1983 in Holy Spirit. But people, I sent about 1300 copies all over the world, no reply. I'm a retired lecturer in metallurgy, metals. I'm a scientist. So I don't have any degree in theology. So that could be the reason that people, you know, when they say, oh, this man, no degree in theology, only MSc in metallurgy, don't bother. However, I found quite interesting, because Christ Jesus was born among the chosen people. And chosen people, they are special people. Abram was brought from Iraq area by Yahweh to come and settle in the Middle East as Adam, Sarah as Eve, and he gave them the promised land, the Garden of Eden. So they are ideal, Adam and Eve, living in the company of Yahweh, the creator of male and female. This is created by Yahweh. The soul inside me is of Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, our supernatural father. So Yahweh is a potter. Same is Brahma, Yahweh, Khuda, same thing. And the soul comes from Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, supernatural fathers. So through them we learn the moral laws. And these have been all told by Christ Jesus. And so this is a model. And in that one Jesus said, you know, in Matthew 13, verse 24 to 30. It is a very interesting parable, but hardly anybody understands it. That when the end of the age, not the word, age, dark age, you know, this is the dark age, comes, I will bundle up the tares and burn them. So the tares are those who are sons of Satan. And the wheat plant are those who are sons of Adam, a noble man. So Abraham was like an Adam, noble man. So if they can build their covenant with Adam or with Abraham, then they are noble men, salt of the earth. If they can't, then they are sons of the Most High, Satan, Al-Jumar, Al-Aqsa, which is in Kaaba. The morality went to Ishmael and spirituality went to Isaac and his people. So that's why when Jesus was young, baby, he was sent to the care of Egyptian under the care of Ishmael, because they wanted to kill him. In the Messianic Jews, chosen people wanted to kill him. Colluded with Herod, and they wanted to kill him. So, through them, we learn a lot. These Holocausts, which took place, they were blind guides leading the blind into the pits. And how blind they were, that they could not build their covenant with Abraham. They became Jew outwardly. So when they become Jew outwardly, then they can't build their covenant with Abraham, because Abraham was not a Jew, but of Semitic race. A Jew is one who is inwardly, spiritual, not physical. This thing is hardly known to any. I must say that I met somebody in Germany. I went to Kirchental there, Catholic. And I asked him, How many Jews died during the Holocaust? He said, zero. I said, how the hell you know this answer? He said, they have split yourself. That is true. So I tried to cooperate with him, told him, you know, let's preach gospel together. He said, oh, he worked in a port or in a hotel. If he preached gospel, they will throw him out. So he was frightened. So here is the covenant of in Adam. Here is Adam. And here is God. Split yourself. Split yourself. Jew is a split yourself. Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, Christian. All are split yourself. They are never born. They never die. These tribal people are born. Tribal people die. So this small, simple fact is hardly known to any. So gospel is for those who have discerning intellect, those who can think themselves, intuition, not those who follow the other like a blind man. Gospel is not for the blind, it gives you light. It tells you, it's like a battery. Battery you use in the darkness to find your path. So you can, with the gospel, you can find your path. You don't get misled. So end of the age has come. And the establishment of Israel after 2000 years is the sign of the end of the age. Matthew 13, verse 24 to 30. When the end come, our bundle of the tares, and they are getting bundled up in Israel for final burning. Tares are sons of the Most High Satan, Al-Dimar Al-Aqsa. And that is in the Hajjarait, and it is on the west side. So how tares are described now and how I can prove it, they are tares. Remember that the destruction of Iraq, that Iraq has weapons of mass destruction, that was a story made by these politicians to destroy Iraq. And who were behind them? The Jews in America, Mammon and media. Jews in America, they rule, they are Israel in disguise, and they rule America. So America is ruled by Israel. And those Jews, they are the one which are supporting them 100%. So here is a poster made by a politician, with a Green Party, but when the It was published in the Jewish newspaper. But when they realized it is anti-Semitic, oh, they took it off quick. But I happened to look at it and print it. And get a copy and print it. So here it is, I just show you. Too many things on my table. Here it is. So this is the one which is made by a Green Party MP, and this is the man having the flag of American flag. Sikhs has the devil's cross. That means the Jews in America, they are causing all this bloodshed. And they started with the land of their forefather, Abraham, Iraq. Now, you tell me, who will start to cut his own roots? So, those who cut their own roots, they are against humanity, against Adam. And they are the sons of Satan. The tears. the wheat plant, therefore uphold the roots. That's why those who will be saved after this destruction in atomic war, they are all mentioned by their tribes. 12,000 are Levi tribe, 12 Benjamin tribe, 12 Judah tribe, so and so, not as Jew. So, this establishment of Israel in 1948, if you add to it 70 years, 70 is made up of 10 times 7. 70 was the outer circle laborers of Jesus who went in pair to baptize the Jewish men in water in the name of Abraham, to make them faithful to Abraham. And then Christ Jesus made them faithful to our supernatural Father, Elohim Allah Parbrahm. So, 1948 plus 70 years made 2018. On 2018, on the Independence Day, Donald Trump, a childlike president, he pressed the tribulation button by declaring Jerusalem to be the capital of Israel. They moved their embassy to Jerusalem, making it the capital. And the tribulation started. Now, atomic war is expected after 5 years because Jesus had 12 laborers. And those 12 laborers had nothing to do with the 12 tribes of Israel. Seven were in the name of John the Baptist, and five were in the name of Christ Jesus of heart. Seven of physical body, seven rituals, menorah. So this menorah, the seven rituals, and they are concerned with our physical body moral laws. So, looking at family, you know. Oh dear me. Never mind. So this one, middle one, is of Elohim, Allah Parbrahm. So this is our supernatural Father God. And these are the pots created by Demiurge Yahweh, Brahma Khuda, the Lord of the nature, potters. That's why the 30 shekels which Judah Iscariot threw was in the temple of Yahweh, the potter. So that's why they buy a field called Potter's Field. And this Potter's Field is everywhere because it's concerned with our earth to earth. This is earth to earth. The soul in us, which makes us living, is from our supernatural Father. So that's why in Christ Jesus, we exercise love called Agape, unconditional divine love, because in everyone, we see the presence of our supernatural Father. Whereas in Moses, you are concerned with your physical body, and that had to perform social, ecumenical, and political affairs, secular affairs. And that's why three are here, three are here, three holy, three evil, opposite, David's cross. So these seven candles is concerned with menorah rituals. Jesus came to fulfill the law. So this one is the one which has the seven in the name of Christ, John the Baptist, times 10. 10 are the religious achievement. So 70 outer circle laborers were in the name of John the Baptist. But the inner was seven from taken from this one, menorah. When the woman married the seventh husband, which is the middle candle, there is neither giving nor taking. So, five is in the name of Christ Jesus of heart of spirituality. So, making it 12. Now, the AD, AD, the era of Christ starts when Jesus was 7 years old, because 7 years here concerning physical body, so after 7 years, you know, then AD starts. And now we are left with 5 years. So in 1948, Israel was established, plus 70 years, the outer circle labor, and the temple was destroyed in 70 AD. So 70 has a lot of other connections as well. So 2018, Trump pressed the tribulation button, and there are 5 more years to atomic war. Atomic war is expected on 14 May 2023. So you can see the world is in tribulation. And this split between America and China is the nucleus of atomic war. So from there on, now the country will split. You will see embassies closed and all that, you know, this United Nations will disappear. One by one, you know, they will be just not joining them anymore. So we are expecting, these are 3 years, remember? Third day is the judgment day. Christ Jesus, for 3 days he was in earth. He did not appear. On third day he appeared. Third is a judgment day. So 2020 plus 3 days, 3 years, 2023 is the judgment year, judgment day. So atomic war is expected on 14 May 2023, and you will see a lot of tribulation in the world. I've written something here. Let me see if I can read it for you. Split between USA and China is the nucleus of atomic war, as expected on 14 May 2023. Just 3 years to go. Trump pressed the tribulation button for the rift between the sons of Abraham. Sons of Abraham are the Samaritans, are the Palestinians. But now they are unfaithful too, you know. Because Abraham was not a Mohammedan outwardly. He was a Muslim inwardly, not outwardly, spiritual. I am a Muslim, spiritual. Outwardly, I am of Jat tribe, Jat. Jat is my tribe from India, Punjab. We are martial tribes. And these British, when they left us, they divided our homeland of Jats, that you are good fighters. And we divide your country. When you fight with each other, then you need weapons. And we will sell you weapons under obligation to kill each other. We made them to win World War I and World War II. We fought for them. And that was the reward we got, because they are tears, sons of Satan. The Church of England, headed by Queen, head of Mammon, is a Church of Mammon, Satan, nothing to do with God. That's why the soldiers who died in World War I, World War II, they say they glorified God. What type of God was that? He was glorified by killing people. Whereas Salvation Army people say they died for king and country, which is right. But they throw them out, they hate them. If you go to St. Paul's Cathedral, there are statues of South Africa, general this and that, and underneath is written, they glorified God. And no statue of our brother William Booth. because he was not fitting there. He was a man of God. Salvation Army people are nearest to God. They exercise love called Agape, unconditional divine love. Not Church of England, it's Rishiest. Remember when Argentinian war was there and Dr. Ramsey wanted to bless the Argentinian soldiers as well. Margaret Thatcher said, no, no, you are employed by Church of England, you can't do it. So, they are Rishiest in God. So that's what you can expect from sons of Satan. So many more things you can learn if you go in tuition and you are brave enough to proclaim gospel from the rooftops and not to be frightened. I tell you this, we had a just this year, we had a sermon from a major general, army major general who retired, and he runs Christian missionary. And he was there in Iraq after the war, and people asked him, did Iraq had weapons of mass destruction? He said, not at all. So Blair and Bush spoke, tell lies from the core of their heart, which is called blasphemy. So they were blasphemers, both of them. And that generalist who threw both his shoes at Bush, he was a hero. Like in the name of Christ Jesus, like Ascendi also, who disclosed their secrets. They fight for humanity. Blair and Bush, they are sons of Satan. They fight for destruction of humanity. That's why they started the destruction with Iraq, the land of their forefather, Jewish forefather of Abraham. So let's see what I have other written. So between some, Trump pressed the button for the rift between the sons of Abraham, Palestinians, and the Jews, outwardly, the tears. Watch my video and I will make one predicting atomic war. This I am making now. Agape is the divine love, greater than Eros of Moses in the wilderness. Remember that you have heard Moses lifted the snake in the wilderness. That snake was not one which wriggled on the ground. It was the rift between the brethren. In Egypt, two brethren were fighting, and Moses passed by and told them, hey, you are brethren, don't fight with each other. One who was aggressor, who said, who the hell made you the judge? Get lost. But in the wilderness, when they were there, they all repented. It's the parable of the prodigal son, Isaac, who left the father Abraham, whereas Ishmael stayed with him, faithful. And they suffered in Egypt, maltreated, and Moses brought them back. The same land became lush green again. So there's much more. This gospel is not difficult at all. It's as simple as ABC. But you must have longing for gospel. It's not that you read book, you know, like a parrot. It is not like, it is hidden underneath. So here is the royal kingdom of God, which Jesus brought in. A helicopter is around, moving. Hope it doesn't disturb us too much. So this is the John the Baptist holding scripture. And here he baptized Jewish men in water in the name of Abraham. and he baptized Jesus in the name of his heavenly Father Yahweh, the creator of male and female. So his body, Jesus, was created by Yahweh impregnated Mary. So Yahweh is the father of Jesus, heavenly Father. Mary was surrogate mother, and Joseph was foster father. That's why he did not leave any mark on this earth, because this earth belonged to the first Adam. That's why Jesus said, foxes are born to rest their head, Son of Man has none. So those who found themselves that when you become Jew outwardly, you become unfaithful to Abraham, unfaithful to Yahweh, they came to John the Baptist. This is the baptism of repentance. This is below. And they were the one who was seeking to go above into the royal vineyard of our supernatural Father, where the true wine Christ Jesus is planted. For that they need to be solitary, to turn their seed, tribal seed, into plant by putting it into the soil. So the plant has the implicit identity of the seed. But it is a plant which can bear fruit. So that plant is to be grafted to the true vine. Twice born people, they graft themselves to the true vine to suck their daily bread. Suck the juice, you know, what came out of the mouth of Jesus. They take it. So this is the plant, spiritual, purely spiritual, as sadhus are, Melchizedek. No money. That's why Jesus, when you go to preaching to, don't take any money in your pocket. No two shoes, no two tunic. And no script. Script, Bible is forbidden here. Bible is the Jewish leaven, which is forbidden here. It is here, scripture, John the Baptist. So those people who put Bible in the hand of Jesus, make him Antichrist. So you can see how stupid they are, you know. St. Paul said, you know, gospel cannot be written down in ink on paper, and they put Bible in his hand. So you have to be a discerning intellect. So here we are all soul concerned. Our soul, not flesh. Whether you are a male or female, brown or black, Jew or Gentile or anything, you know, all we have one. We are the sons of the Most High. Our soul is concerned, not our physical body. So these twice born people are the one we need to fish. That's why we are fishers of men, not of women. Women are those who follow other blindly. Like Saul, when he was a disciple of Gamaliel, he was a woman to Gamaliel. And Jesus set him free, then he became independent, and he became Paul. He started preaching gospel from the rooftop. So this is the purely spiritual world. This is secular. This is called celestial world, above celestial. So purely spiritual, sadhus. So saint is a saint here, no saintess here. So all saints, you know, sons of the Most High. That's why Jesus came to make us the sons of the Most High, saint. And here we have prophet. John the Baptist was the last prophet. So Luke 16 verse 16, law and prophet were telling John the Baptist. Law, transgression against the moral law, is called sin. So sin was till John the Baptist. No sin after that one, but blasphemy, hypocrisy. As you saw this, Bush and Blair hypocritically told the general public. And over there they went to Iraq to give all these speeches, you know. That man, generous, throwed both his shoes at that Bush, you know. He did very, very well. He is the hero. So in Reading, where I live, recently a man killed three people. They were the Lamb of God. They were killed, innocent people. And that was the reaction of those people who were displaced from their homelands. So they displaced the people, which were innocent people, lambs of the God, from Iraq, Libya, and other places, where they, Syria and other places, and made them refugees, homeless. So is that the right thing to do? So they have killed their bombs, American bombs and UK bombs. They killed so many people, innocent lambs of God. And this man just killed three in Reading, and there's a hue and cry. This is just a splinter. There's a plank in the eyes of Blair and Bush, and nobody watches that one. They just accuse this man. This is why he should be here, this Iraqi, this Libyan man. Because his home was destroyed by these bombs. They are innocent people, lambs of the God. And there will be more killing and such things happening in the world, especially where the people have used their bombs to destroy their homes. God is not sleeping, he is awake. Whatever you sow, so shall you reap. If you are sowing good thing, you reap good thing. If you have to eat evil, now is the time to reap the reward of evil before the atomic war takes place in 2023. So our Father God bless you in Agape, which is this love, you know. Remember that Moses created arrows, tribal love, and no more rift. And in Jesus, greater than Moses on international basis. This is tribal, this is international. Agape. That is the message of peace. That's why Jesus said, peace can be only done by these people, twice born. So that's the message of peace, in the name of peacemakers are here. And this is filial love, philosophical, when you understand gospel. And then we, at Pentecost, when they got the very spirit of God, then they are storge love. This is Greek words of the arrows, agape, and philia, and storge. Four spiritual states and four types of loves. Much more if you are interested. And I leave it here, quite a lengthy video. Our Father God blesses you. And watch my videos and learn some basic of gospel. You don't need any book to read. Gospel is here, and it is for the living people who can think logically. If you can't think logically, you can't have gospel. So inside here is the Christ. So the people who are having people of the book, they are Christians. Once born people, they see, but they don't perceive. They are Christians. Whereas the Christ, they perceive. They see and perceive. And they are Christ. So I am a Christ and not a Christian. So in India, St. Thomas went there, and those to whom he preached gospel, like Christ Jesus preached to his 12 laborers, they were known as Christ, not as Christian. It was Pope who went there and burned their books and all that he did, Antichrist activity, and then they were turned into Christian. But before, they were all known as Christ, the primary source of light. That means we can do logical reasoning ourselves. We are no more orphan. We are not orphan. Orphans are the disciples of the rabbis. If the books are burnt, scripture is burnt, they are orphan, they will be crying like hell, you know. But we don't cry because our gospel cannot be written on an ink or paper, it's written here. Our treasures are here, our treasures are where our heart is, and not in the book or in any bank, you know. So, very simple thing, and it's up to you to come forward and help myself and help yourself. I need technical help. I've written a book, which is One God, One Faith, and it needs to be published, you know. I need some technical help. And here is the kingdom of heaven and hell of the rabbis. And here is the royal kingdom of God. It is of heart. Christianity is of heart. That's why Pilate, when he asked Jesus, what type of king you are? They are saying you are the king. Then Jesus told them that if my kingdom was of this nature, outside, as the rabbis were rulers, you know, if I were ruler, you know, my soldiers would have come and fight against you. Opposite applied to spirit. He was super servant, our Christ Jesus. So he told him, I'm this one, you know, here, I'm a super servant, and my kingdom is within my heart and not outside. So mine is royal kingdom. And when Pilate understood this gospel truth, then he told the Jewish people, hey, he has done nothing wrong. But they wanted to kill him out of jealousy. So that's why he made the plank king of the Jews, because they proclaimed him to be the king, but he wasn't the king. Rebellion against Pilate. So that's why he wrote king of the Jews, and later on the temple priest came telling Pilate, please remove that plank, he's not our king. So that is the secret of the why the plank was put king of the Jews. Much more, it's very simple, you know, it's all here. You can't, if you start looking in the books, you know, you are spiritually dead. You can't have gospel at all. It's all here, logical reasoning. Our Father God blesses you in Agape, unconditional divine love. Remember, St. Paul said, without love, I'm nothing. And that is the love we extend here in the name of Christ Jesus, which is Agape,